안녕하세요. 영국의 이제 음원 유통사 루트노트에서 한국 파트를 담당하고 있는 최윤희라고 합니다. 오늘은 정말 귀중한 아티스트 이쌈을 모시고 왔어요. 그래서 인터뷰를 진행을 하게 되었습니다. 함께 같이 소개를 해드려볼게요. 안녕하세요.
안녕하세요.
이미 한국에 또 많은 팬들을 보유하고 계신데 그런 느낌을 체감하시는지 궁금합니다.
Yeah, I do actually. Yeah, it's really cool. It's really it's lovely. It's really nice. Like, you know, coming here to the hotel, there was fans in the hotel. Some of the staff was have heard my music before. So yeah, it's kind of a bit weird, but I love it. It's really really nice. Yeah, it's very nice.
그래서 아주 짧게 우리 한국 팬분들한테 인사 한마디 부탁드릴게요.
Annual in Korea, Ethan. I'm Ethan in Seoul. It's always a pleasure to come here and do shows or write. So yeah, thank you so much for having me and thank you for making me feel so welcome and so loved. Thank you. 감사합니다.
감사합니다. 어디서 태어났고 그리고 얼마나 몇 살이시고 이런 기본적인 것들 어디에 사시는지.
Yeah, I was born in a place called Reading, which is just outside of London. It's like 30 minutes out of London. I've lived there all my life. It's been quite difficult to move out of Reading because it's so close to London. So I work in London and been working there for like over 10 years now. So Reading means a lot to me, but it's nice to get out as well and come to a beautiful place like this. So yeah.
그러면 지금도 런던 아까 그 근교에 살고 계시다고 들었는데 현재 살고 있는 곳도 그 나라이시고 그 장소이신지도 궁금합니다.
Yeah, I am. Yeah. I've actually just moved house recently in the last week or so. So yeah, so I've moved I think about 15 times but stayed in Reading. It's a good hub for me. I feel like it's a good place because, like I said, it's close to London. It's good train links, and it kind of feels a bit like home. Like when I go back to Reading, so it'll be hard to move out of there.
그러면 이제 음악을 시작하게 되신 계기가 어떻게 될지 궁금해요. 집에서 혹은 주변 사람들이 이렇게 푸시를 하거나 응원을 해주거나 하는 일이 있었는지.
It kind of started, I don't know, like I was introduced to a lot of music when I was younger. Music was always being played everywhere, in the car, in the house, and it was always a big thing, I think, to my family. And I just sort of gravitated towards guitar music and, you know, bands like Queen, Brian May, you know, I just thought the guitarist looked so cool having a guitar. So from an early age, like I really wanted to learn how to play the guitar, and I had like a few lessons when I was younger, but then I stopped for probably over a year, and then I got my first guitar again, and it just kind of spiraled. Like I just learned all my favorite songs, and I kind of just the singing came after, and I kind of did like school concerts, school talent shows. And then kind of developed into, you know, going busking on the streets. And I actually, like, I used to busk in Guildford on the high street, which, yeah, I used to do that quite a lot. And it was a lot of fun. And, yeah, and then it sort of just, I kind of knew from in school that I really wanted to write songs and I really wanted to be an artist and sing on stage. Like, and I think I really enjoyed the writing and just really, I found it so cool that you could write your own song because like when you were a kid, you listened to a song and then when I found out, you know, because you're young, like when you found out, oh, I could write a song, I kind of just thought, oh, that's pretty cool. So it kind of all spiraled from there really, and from school onwards. And I was kind of lucky to have like a management when I was 15 that just really pushed me and developed me, and yeah, it just kind of went from there. And yeah, it's a lot of cool memories, a lot of good memories, and yeah, I really enjoyed those days actually. It's good fun.
너무 멋진데요. 보통 이렇게 곡을 만드시거나 제작을 하실 때 어디에서 영감을 얻으시는지?
For my stuff, a lot of it's to do with things that I guess like lyrically is what I've gone through and been through, and I try and channel some of the stuff that I have been through into a song, whether it's like, you know, heartache or happiness or a happy time. And you know, and I think musically, I think I just love to keep it in an acoustic world, you know. I think when I write a song, I think about what I want to be like up on stage, and I don't dance. I try, you know, I do movement to a very minimal, and so when I write a song, I try and picture what it would be like, you know, how would I perform this song up on stage, and normally it's just, you know, having the guitar as like the base of the song, and then just some sort, you know, and try and find a melody, whether it's happy or sad, that sort of conveys what I want to say in some stuff. Normally it's sad. sad songs, but you know, that's why I love writing all types of different music for other people as well, just so I can actually, you know, not write as sad songs. But yeah, there's so many artists from the UK. You know, I grew up on Elton John, Queen, you know. Yeah, so many amazing artists that's the sort of area that I saw myself in. So yeah, those type of artists.
매우 흥미로운데요. 그러면 혹시 곡을 만드실 때 가장 좋아하는 장르, 그리고 내가 귀로 들었을 때 좋아하는 장르가 같으실지도 궁금해요.
No, not really. I never really listen to the music that is my genre, I guess. I mean, I'm sort of the person that would listen to like one artist or one band for months, you know, like for a long time. Like in my car last year, and it was for the whole year, I had Fleetwood Mac in the car, and it's just, I should listen to the radio, but I don't because I kind of don't like listening to the radio. I just like listening to one artist for a long time, because that's what you did back in the day. Like, you know, you'd buy a CD, your mum would let you buy one CD for like, you know, well, you'd probably get one on your birthday or something, and that'd be it. So you just kind of play that on repeat. So yeah, it's not really, not the music, I don't listen to what I write musically, yeah.
그러면 평소 곡을 안 만드시고 있으실 때, 쉴 때는 어떠한 취미를 가지고 즐기시는지도 궁금합니다.
To be honest, I just kind of hang out with friends. Like I have like two best mates from at home that, you know, we kind of just do, I don't know, we'll probably play some football or something, or just, you know, not a lot, because I'm generally sort of working and doing a lot of songs, and I really do enjoy, you know, staying up late and you know, cutting vocals or making a song. But yeah, I think, yeah, if I'm, you know, we'll probably do some sports, you know, play golf, play some football, or games, you know, PlayStation sometimes. Oh. Yeah, that's, you know, it's quite fun. But yeah, like not crazy amounts of different, I don't know. I'm quite consumed with music, which I really enjoy. So I guess what I love to do when I'm not doing music is just fully relaxing and just watching films and TV shows and stuff like that, really. Yeah.
그러면 우리가 이제 살아갈 때 각자 또 이제 인생의 모토가 있을 것 같은데.
I personally think my motto is you just gotta go with what makes you happy, and just really, really not give up on it, and just, and you know, there were, even through the hard times, like I had, it was quite a struggle the last couple years, and I think what I kept saying to myself all the time was just that you gotta keep going, you know. I think it's so cliche in a way, but it's so true. I remember hearing a lot of people, or a lot of people that are successful, say, oh, you just got to keep going, be patient, wait for your time, like, keep going. And I thought it was absolute rubbish. I thought, nah, this is, it's just so, I don't know, it's just not working out for me. But, it, you know, eventually it actually does. I think the persistence and your, you know, dedication, hard work and sacrifice, I think it does. It might not pay off in a way that it really does, but it slowly gets to that place where you feel like it's rewarding you and it's happening. So, yeah, you just got to do what makes you happy, really, and just really, really be persistent and go for it, yeah.
지속적으로 이렇게 노력해서 앞으로 나가는 거는 우리 모두에게도 필요한 일인 것 같습니다. 이제 최신 곡, Hearts Out Loud에 mm-hmm. 대한 곡을 조금 여쭤보고 싶어요. 이 곡에 대해서 짧게 한번 설명해 주시겠어요?
That me and my friends sort of worked on, and it was, you know, I heard Danny's voice basically, and that's what started it all. I just really wanted a song, like do a song with her because her voice was so good. And she had this idea of Hurts Out Loud, and I fully fell in love with it. And you know, it was just a really touching song. And once I heard it, I just thought we have to do this. So yeah, I was, she's amazing, and so is Angus, the producer. And yeah, it was just really nice because I love the guys. We're really close friends, so it just felt right to do this track. Yeah.
그럼 원래부터 친구 사이셨던 건가요?
Yeah, Angus, I've known for a while. Danny, I didn't know as long. I kind of heard her voice, and then we sort of became friends. But Angus, I knew for a long time. We'd worked on loads of songs together, and yeah. But Danny was the sort of, if you ever met her, Danny's the sort of girl that as soon as you meet her, you're like instantly best friends. Like, she's so nice and just so energetic and lovely. So yeah.
그럼 요 근래에 이제 라이브 영상을 또 봤는데 한국 팬분들이 그 목소리에 완전 매료가 되었다고 하고 있어요. 그 곡에 대해서 한 에피소드가 있었을까요? 라이브 공연을 하시면서?
When we did the live video, I really wanted to do a live version because one, I thought the live version would really cut, like put across that emotion behind the song. Because it's quite an emotional song, and I thought if we didn't do it live, then we would. I don't think we'd be serving the song right. Like, it needed that full emotion from both of us to really just showcase the song and show how emotional it is. But yeah, it was a lot of fun doing that video. Yeah.
그러면 지금 마성의 목소리라는 별명을 들을 정도로. 모든 많은 팬분들이 지금 듣고 계신데요. 그러면 나의 목소리에 대해서 본인이 직접 어떻게 생각하시는지도 궁금합니다.
I worked a lot on it when I was younger. I think it went through different stages. When I was younger, I felt like I was trying to sing too much, too hard. But now it's like a little bit more relaxed, I feel. Yeah, I think a voice changes so much, and I think I much prefer the way I sound now than I did as a young. I think, yeah, when you're younger, you know, you're just learning your voice. You're testing out new things, your boundaries, your top notes and your low notes. But yeah, to me, it is kind of annoying though. Yeah. I get sick of it.
그러면 그 라이브 영상을 찍으실 때 장소를 이제 고르셨을 것 같은데 특정 의미가 있을까요?
Yeah, me and my videographer, there's sort of like locations that he was aware of and knew, and so we just sort of looked through some of the options of where we could do it, and we found that place, and I thought it just had like quite a good gritty vibe, and it was just, you know, it had a good sort of overlook of London as well, and the room, it kind of felt fitting for the song. I didn't want it to look too nice. You know, I wanted it to look kind of rough, and that place just felt kind of perfect for it. So, yeah.
그러면 이번에는 올해 공연이 진행이 됐었던 서울 재즈 페스티벌에 대해서 여쭤보고 싶은데요. 어떻게 방문을 하게 되셨는지 그 소감도 한번 듣고 싶습니다.
It was a huge highlight of my life. It was amazing. It was so, Yeah, it was a real, full circle moment. I think it was just amazing just to again like travel all this way from home, and I, to be honest, I was just in a bit of like a shock state. I think on stage, I just couldn't believe that people actually knew my songs. And the really funny and the really cool part was, you know, as I started the set, like people were running down the front to kind of try and get like a good spot, and I was just, you know, it's just a bit like a, it was just really, really cool. It was just, it was, I was so, I don't know, I was so touched and it was so grateful. I think all of us, my band members as well, we couldn't quite believe it. We were just like, this is amazing. And then especially at the end when we all sung 1245 and everybody sung, I was just a bit like, yeah, it was just like kind of, I think for one chorus I didn't sing it because I just I wanted to just watch and just see, you know. But yeah, that was, I was so grateful for that moment, and I hope I get to do it again sometime soon. But yeah, that was, yeah, well, definitely one of my favorite moments in my career, 100%. Really, really cool. Yeah.
그 공연이 첫 번째 공연이었을지도 궁금해요, 한국에서.
It was, yes, yeah, and what a treat it was to perform in front of so many people and at a beautiful festival as well. Yeah, I felt so lucky for that to be my first performance in Korea, yeah.
그러면 이렇게 또 성황리에 공연을 하셨는데 다음 솔로 공연 혹은 이런 공연장에서 페스티벌에 참여를 하실 의사가 있으실지 계획이 있으실지도 궁금합니다.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, I don't know how much I can say, but next year 100% doing more shows, hopefully going to be doing shows here. Yeah, and then I've got the EP coming out early next year as well, so we'll have 7 tracks that I'm hoping to tour with. It's going to be a busy year next year. Yeah, it's going to be great.
너무 기대가 되는데요. 꼭 그 날짜를 저도 체크를 해서 공연장에 참여하기를 기대합니다. 그러면 다음으로 넘어가 볼게요. 그 이번에 송캠프 라이팅 세션이 있다고 해서 오셨다고 들었어요. 근데 곡을 엄청 빨리 많이 좋은 곡을 쓰셨다고 들었는데 보통은 곡 쓰실 때 어느 정도 시간이 소요되는지도 궁금합니다.
It kind of varies. My process is kind of, I think it, my process might be frustrating for some people, but I kind of like, it can take up to like, you know, like it can be 10 minutes sometimes, and it can then sometimes be, you know, a couple hours type of thing. I think, yeah, it definitely varies. It just all depends on what the vibe is saying in the room. But yeah, it can be pretty. I like to keep it kind of quick, you know, because I get bored quite quickly. So like, you know, I just like to keep it quick. And if it's not happening straight away, then it's probably, well, again, it varies. I was going to say it's probably not worth it, but then sometimes it actually is. So it just all depends on, you know, what's happening in that moment. But I like to kind of keep it quick and fresh and try and like do like, at least, you know, spend the first 3 hours of the session coming up with as many ideas as possible, and then, you know, pick one to really go in on and finish. So yeah.
소문에 의하면 또 이제 유명한 K-pop 아티스트들의 곡도 많이 만드셨다고 들었어요. 근데 가장 이 곡은 내가 생각해도 너무 좋아라고 생각하는 곡이 있을까요?
Oh, it's like asking who's your favorite child, isn't it? I'm kind of, yeah, I don't think there's not one particular one. I'm really happy with all the songs, and I'm again so grateful that people like them enough to take them and feel like they can sing them and make the song their own. And all the songs that I've written for other people, when they sing them, they really do a great job, and I'm just so happy that, you know, they feel like it's their song as well. So, but yeah, I don't think there's one specific one though. Yeah.
그러면 이제 한국에 오셔서 이렇게 많은 파트너분들과도 이제 음악 작업을 하실 것 같은데 가장 호흡이 잘 맞으셨던 분이 있을까요? 그분에 대해서도 한번 살짝 소개 부탁드릴게요.
Yeah. Well, I guess the most recent one was Chen. And that was great to work with. Yeah, he's a phenomenal artist, like part of a big band as well, and his solo project is, yeah, so good. Yeah, I was really happy that he felt like my song, you know, he could take on and make his own. So Yeah, Chem's great. And but yeah, like in terms of my music as well, like Danny was amazing to work with. So you know, she was just so great, so funny, and so easy. It was lovely, yeah.
진짜 그 보이스가 좋다는 건 정말 너무 매력적인 부분인 것 같아요. 그러면 한번 또 이제 이렇게 한국에 오셔서 이번 여행 여정 일정이 어떻게 되는지 궁금합니다.
It's been really busy. It's like been a lot of songs, a lot of writing. It's basically yeah. I've come here this week to do mainly writing for some artists and stuff like that. And yeah, it's been a mix of no sleep, writing, and food and bed. Well, just about bed, just about sleep. So yeah, but no, it's so like again, like I feel so happy to be here and to be able to do my job out here and people and work with such amazing people. Yeah.
그럼 드셨던 음식 중에 한국 음식 중에 가장 맛있었던 거 기억에 남는 게 있으실까요?
Oh man. What was the thing we had on Sunday, the first night?
Oh,
shabu shabu. Amazing. All the food. I was telling all my friends. I was like, you have no idea how bad the English food is compared to out here. It's so nice. Yeah, Korean barbecue is another amazing food. Yeah, really, really nice food. It's amazing.
한국 고기 엄청 맛있죠. 그러면 너무 바쁘셔서 관광은 하나도 못 하셨을 것 같은데 그래도 오시기 전에 여기는 꼭 가보고 싶다 하셨던 곳이 있으실까요?
No, I haven't done much sightseeing actually. I haven't really, but everywhere that I have gone has been really nice. So I kind of consider that as a little bit of sightseeing. But you know, I don't know too many places around in Seoul, but. I'm sure like the next time I'm here we're going to do a much longer trip so I can have a little look around and see some of the stuff but like you know
over there
like seeing just being here and looking around feels enough you know it feels amazing and some of the studios have been great and obviously last when I was here in May being doing the festival I mean that was amazing to look at and be a part of so yeah
그러면 이제 저희 팬분들은 항상 이제 새로운 소식들을 빠르게 접하고 싶어 하실 것 같은데 SNS 채널 중에서 어떠한 채널에서 우리가 소식을 가장 빠르게 받아볼 수 있을까요?
It's probably Instagram mainly. I'm not like too great with my social media sometimes, but yeah, Instagram I use a lot because I feel like that's where most of my fans are. But Facebook and Twitter, and then like TikTok is, I guess, more of it's not really like where you post news, I guess, you just kind of, yeah, TikTok, so that's that thing. But yeah, Instagram is probably the best platform, I think, to feel like you can get the most, you know, whatever I'm up to or information.
그러면 Instagram ID 소개 부탁드릴게요.
Should I do this?
Like this.
Oh, cool. Yeah, so it's just at Ethan with an M on the end for mother. Yeah, that's another question or another... I don't know why it's Ethan. My parents say it sounds more British. It should have been Ethan. Like, it gets mistaken all the time. But yeah, it's just at Ethan, which we managed to get like a few years ago. So yeah, you can find me on that.
그러면 다음 앨범에 대해서 이제 내년 초쯤이라고 말씀을 해주셨는데 살짝 소개를 해주실 수 있을까요?
I've got a new single coming out in January, which I'm really looking forward to because it's a song that I've had for a long time, and it means a lot to me. It's probably one of my favorite songs that I've written. And then the rest of the EP drops in February time. So yeah. Yeah, there's still like a lot of work to get done. Like we need to finish like a few more songs, and also I'm always trying to write better songs because I always like get to a point where I feel like that song could have been better. So yeah, hopefully. But yeah, we've got a deadline. It's gonna come out in February, but the next single's in January. So, yeah.
꼭 팬분들 날짜 기억하셨다가 같이 들으러 가도록 하죠. 그러면 마지막으로 짧은 단어로 단답형으로 대답해 주시면 좋을 것 같은 질문 한 세 가지 정도 가져왔습니다. 이쌈에게 음악이란 무엇인가요?
Life.
멋있어요. 그러면 이쌈이란 세 가지 단어로 표현을 해주세요.
Unprepared, unorganized, and don't know what's going on half the time.
앞으로의 포부와 계획을 듣고 싶습니다.
Yeah, I guess my future plans, like I would love to maybe try and do two EPs or just put an album out at the end of next year. But I guess I don't know, my future plans is I just would love to be able to continue writing for me and for other artists, and also, you know, try and help artists in a way that I can, you know, in whatever way I can in terms of development and advice, ideas. Yeah, I just always want to be in this circle of music and around, you know, great people, and yeah, just be in the music life. I think that's where I feel comfortable and best at. Yeah.
네, 그러면 이제 마지막으로 인터뷰를 마무리하기 전에 한국 팬분들에게 인사 부탁드릴게요.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you so much. For, I don't know, having such a big impact on my life and just helping, you know, and yeah, kind of, I don't know, just thank you so much. I just really, really appreciate the love and the support and, you know, for liking my songs and for staying for so long. Like, there's been fans that have been around for a long time, so it's just, yeah, when I say it means a lot, I really, really mean it. And it's, yeah, thank you just so much. 감사합니다.
아, 네. 저희도 좋은 시간 같이 함께 해주셔서 너무 감사합니다. 감사합니다.
감사합니다. Can I say nothing for now? 'Cause it hurts to say out loud.